Time to continue ultimate torment and torture. I'll finish my glass of milk. Oh wait, I gotta load the game. Alright. So we are on some kind of high mountain thingy. All I know, and I know the frame rate was also kind of shit here. Oh my god, new enemies. I did not even notice that. What's that? That's a bomb. I thought that was an item. That's a bomb he dropped. Holy damn. But yeah, the frame rate is pretty weird because of this wad. It's very heavy. Because it's very big and open. Doom can't handle big open areas very well. A little bit of a problem. Look like a grenade from Shadow War without the spike. Yeah, kinda. You are very right about that. Ow. See, I just grabbed some health and now we're fucking down again. So I talked to Light. He should arrive tonight, I hope. He did say he was gonna, but who knows. Oh my god, we're being shot by something in the air. Ow. Alright, let's go. Let's save. Oh crap, more health, yes please. So I've been playing Quake Champions a lot lately, and I would be streaming that if I could, but I have too much frame drops playing Quake Champions to be able to enjoy that while I'm streaming it, so my apologies for that. Even in lowest graphic settings, that just becomes not playable for me. Too much frame rate drop. Damn these frickin' campers. Yeah, there's cool new enemies in here. They're basically like mini Hell Knights. Oh my god. Yeah, let's use this tree as cover for fire. Always very useful. Hide behind a tree if someone is using a flamethrower. Definitely the best strategy. You guys know that, right? You are all very well educated. There's some new imps as well, which started appearing in this map. Take care of this lost soul. Well, hopefully the imps will infight with the demons. Well, not really. Well, there's the black imps with the purple fireballs, but there's also the brown imps over here with the spikes and stuff. They shoot pretty fast. And there's also the dark shadow imps over here with the red balls. A lot of different imp variations. Ow. God fucking damn it. And that was on the blue armor. And light. I think I lost my leader, but oh goddamn. I hope everything is alright, man, and it's fine, you didn't miss a lot because I spent a lot of minutes talking about the new headphones because this is tape. Because that broke off. Thankfully, tape holds it together a little bit. But yeah, new headphones will be required in the near future. But thankfully, these still work. And it's being held together by good tape. Uh-oh. Hold on. The revs are coming early today. Ow. Damn freaking things. Okay. Oh shit. I will say that this WOD is very hard. It's a very chaotic WOD. Speaking of, my phone just lights up telling me that its power is low, so let me actually plug that in. So that, oh god, no. Fuck your... bullshit. Shenanigans. Pain elemental. Oh god. We need more ammos. We need more health. Like, you're constantly on the frickin' struggle with health and ammo in this WOD. In a weird survival kind of way. I feel like I'm needing to survive. Well, I'm hoping you're doing better now. There's a pleb. Oh my god, what the fuck? That is bullshit. I'm not allowed to climb that. What's the shenanigans? Well, this one doesn't crash, so I'm just gonna have to. Oh my god. It was the other one. Okay, so I guess you need to like follow a freaking route here. Okay, we got more knights. How the fuck did I manage to walk into that? I I'm telling you, this is one tough wad. It's tough. Like, there's not a lot of breathing room in this wad. And I like it. Like, it's, I like the challenge of this wad. And yes, Suiciders also make a bit of an appearance in here. His head fell off. And yes, there's special lost souls here as well. So many enemy varieties. Hexen enemy? I don't think so. We'll have to creep up the stairs. Lost my shooting as a result of the shoulder shot out. Yeah, I had some issues today helping my mother throw out an old dishwasher and an old fridge. And my back really hurt bad after that. I like this minigun. If only I had a bit more ammo. Oh, okay, Slayer dude. Understandable. Ah! There's something attacking from behind as well. Oh, there's like a Kako somewhere up here. Oh, there he is. Oh, it's multiple ones. I have a feeling it was Kakos. Have a good night, Slayer dude, in case you fall asleep, yeah. Good man. Hope things get better. Oh my god, a stim pack. Oh crap, we got. Fuck. Look at those fuckers incoming. Oh, they're dead. I think they went infighting or something. See that? Yes, there are Arachnotrons shooting railguns. You've seen that very well. Save here. Yeah, there's a lot of enemies that are available in realm 667. I like a lot of these. They're pretty cool. I'm a big sucker for those believable enemies that feel like they could be in the real Doom. Just not a fan of simple reskins like Grey Kako Demons or some stuff like that. If they're now, they gotta have some real sprite art worked into them, then I start to really like them. Now, stuff like that Silver Hell Knight or the Shielded Hell Knights, those are cool. But if it's like only a recolor, then I'm not a fan. I want more than a recolor, you know? I want to grab that. Not yet. Like, these guys are also cool. These are more than just an imp recolor. That's why I like them. Yeah, exactly. The believable ones that feel like they could have been an official Doom expansion. Nope. This is all 2007. Don't forget that. Playing 2007 WoD here. Still 12 years old. This WoD is. Can't believe that. I think those are the Black Manx. Or the Gray Manx. Dark Manx. Like, again, I'm not a big fan of these because they're just a recolor, you know? They look the same. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna need some bigger hardware. Ow! So many rockets that flew up into the air. Oof. The scenes a few years ago back then. 2004 or 5. Oh yeah, we're on the slope, definitely. Uh-oh. These guys I like as well. They're very cool. We got past that. These guys are very cool. I'm even thinking of adding some of these enemies to my own WoD. And then I'm just gonna make two versions of my WoD. One with custom enemies, one without the custom enemies, so that people can still use, like, gameplay mods. Alright. So here we get Grapsol. Press F to pay respects. Strunk to RIP to pay even more respects. If you're not a subscriber, then press F for to pay respects. If you are a subscriber, press Strunk to RIP for to pay respects. Thank you very much, Bouncy. Also pay respects. A Lord Vader, of course, our mighty Lord Vader, who brought us to the dark side. And the Dark Archon as well. And the Solar Snowfall, we can't forget them. And the Scuba Steve as well. And we got Cutman Mike. Hey, Galactic. We got Doom Dude. NJ. Orion's. Andy, Phobus, what's this, Kextos, and Hyrogen 2, some odd names. Oh, these revenants look cool though. Look, these are cool. These are not just recolors. These look pretty cool. They're meant to be statues most likely though. They'll probably come alive. Hit scan laser revenants. Idea of the Doomflow, the meme mod with the reference make me think it's kinda don't think I checked it out yet. I was very bummed out yesterday about the photos not being available that I made. Like if I press print screen here, see it's hold on. I died again. So I press print screen. There are Terminator games out there. Like Future Shock. Future Shock. So if I go to screenshots now in my GZ Doom folder. See, I just made this screenshot. Yeah, 4 January, and it just gives me a black screen. It's literally just a black screen, a screenshot file, because I'm streaming. It does not want to make proper screenshots. I don't know how to fix it. It's just happening when I'm streaming. And I don't know if there's a way to kind of have an alternative, but I can't make screenshots. Maybe only with, like... No, actually... What? He's still alive? I thought he was dead. The fuck is happening? That explains a lot. Apparently they come back alive. Okay, well, what the fuck? How do I get past them? They don't come back to me. Okay, that's where we got. Oh crap, he's following me. The fucking cuck. Because everyone thought a hit scanning revenant would be a good idea. Should have known that. Only I would have known that. Fucking Christ. What the fuck is that splash, dude? Who the fuck thought a fucking hit scanning revenant was a good idea? He keeps killing me because he can just hit scan me. Yeah, and now he survived, of course. So he's gonna come back to life again. And then he's gonna insta-kill me. Fucking dumb, because... he doesn't fucking die. Again, he doesn't fucking jib. I'm gonna have to fucking keep loading. Oh, I don't have a BFG, sadly. Look at those fucking misses! Jesus Christ almighty! And he doesn't jib, so I might as well load, because he'll come back alive. He just keeps killing me. Doesn't jip, load the game. So dumb. Doesn't jip, load the game. That's what we gotta do now. Keep loading the fucking game until the fucking thing dies. Properly, because apparently it's fucking dumb. I need to be lucky to have them killed properly, and they move too fast to fucking kill with a rocket. Gee, that's incredibly fucking dumb. Yep, they're definitely OP. A fucking hit-scanning revenant, are you fucking dumb? Look at that bullshit. Nope, that does not work. Why does he not jib all of a sudden? He fucking did that earlier. Look, he's not fucking jibbing. Fucking Christ, man. That's fucking retarded. Okay, I'm done. It doesn't even fucking do that. Why did it work earlier and now it doesn't? What's with the inconsistency here? What's with the inconsistency? Why does he not fucking jib? I'm using a fucking rocket launcher, you dumb fucking game. Well, I did it earlier. I know how it works. Nope, doesn't fucking work. There you go, you asshole. I'll MDK your dumb friend as well, so I don't have to fucking bother with them anymore. How about that? Because I've killed them as many times as I need to. I would have had the health if I didn't fucking have to deal with their bullshit resurrecting bullcrap as well. Speaking of, if they can resurrect, I can also resurrect. Resurrecting them enemies. Like, that was just dumb. Like, you're gonna make... if you're gonna make a resurrecting enemy, fine, do that. But don't make him a fucking hit scanner. Don't make a fucking hit scanning revenant that also resurrects himself. That's dumb. Too far in for my taste. And if he doesn't want to jib, I'll just MDK him, because that'll be a jib guaranteed, right? And I've killed them plenty of times. Just didn't have the health to tank him because you're kind of forced to take damage when you're taking on a hit scanner. Where did that come from? I just randomly exploded. Oh, there's like a Baron dude. What the fuck is this? What the fuck is that? That's the fucking ball that came out of the Revenant. Yeah, apparently that fucking still chases me. That's bullshit. Like, those Revenants are like the biggest bullshit ever that this ward has. Of course, he hits me through this fucking building. You can't even stay safe behind cover from these fuckers. They're pretty cool, but kind of not in the mood to deal with them like that to right after those Revenants, because those Revenants have pissed me off a little bit, you know. It's like I lost way too much unnecessary health because of those Revenants. Well, you'll have to do a lot of modding if you want them in Project Brutality. Yeah, it's like... If it were regular Revenants, like, either make them hit scan or make them revive. Not make them hit scan and revive, that's too much. That's where I draw the line where it's like... too much of a bullshit. Like, don't make any hit scanner that can revive itself, okay? If you want me to kill an enemy by jibbing it, otherwise it will revive, fine, but don't make it a hit scanner. That's dumb. Because hit scanners will guaranteed do damage. That's just how hit scanners work. Scanners in the open are cheap. But the rest of the world is absolutely amazing. I mean, I fought those big Baron thingies. Yeah, Project Brutality is very complicated, Slayer dude. Like, putting that in requires a lot of knowledge. Like, that's... you can't just put in... an enemy. Like, you could put it in, but it would not work properly like in Project Brutality. Like, it wouldn't have any proper death animations or jibs. Like, you can put them in as a standard enemy, but it's not like they're gonna be, you know, there's a difference between putting an enemy in your WoD and putting an enemy and incorporating it into Project Brutality. Because when they add an enemy into Project Brutality, they add animations, they add death animations. They do a lot of editing with the sprites. I mean, if you literally want to import them into your mod, you can do that. I'm not sure how you could make them spawn as those enemies, though. That would have been the only issue, but you could... it would be easy to make a map and put them in your map. That's way easier. fucking my mini spiders fuck off, please. I hate them. Fucking Christ almighty. Fucking cancer spiders. I'm sorry, but they're so fucking annoying because they're small and fast like crazy. They're absolutely fucking annoying. My apologies, but I'm just frustrated. Like, I dealt with these spiders earlier yesterday. They also had like mini spiders coming out of them. They were annoying, but at least I had a lot of maneuvering space to take care of them. But here it's like I'm being engaged by this other barren creature, you know? So it's like so fucking annoying to just have them fuck around while you're just, you know, hopefully things will start getting back to normal. I start forgetting about those revenants. I like this guy is like a reskin of a Baron. He's just darker red with black pants. Nice. Got him in fighting. It's like Pokemon. Oh, I killed him. Nice. That's one less freaking Arachnotron to deal with. He does look pretty cool for a recolor. But he is sadly just a recolor. Now we got an Aphrit there. Bad memories of Aphrits in Scythe 2, but thankfully in this one they're actually pretty good. I believe these fuckers are actually in Project Brutality as well. I like the fire they make. I'm gonna drink a little bit of water. Yeah, I've definitely seen those flying ones in Project Brutality.
Time to light the barbecue. Time to light the barbecue.
Damn arachnotrons. Ooh, this looks like it could be a secret though. Maybe like a megasphere or something nice. Oh my god, really? Fucking kill us. Oh, we can't even get up here, okay. Yeah, the flying one. That one is in Project Brutality, as far as I know. I believe I have seen it. Oh nice, she's in fighting though, that's good. Oh, we got her. Good. But there is a Mega Sphere on there. Holy crap, I was actually correct. There is a fucking Mega. Oh wow, hey there, HM4L. Thank you for the host. I did not expect you to show up. Long time no see. Go to bed. Hell no. This is my normal streaming time. So I was right, there is a Mega here. Good stuff. Oh, we've reached the top. Bruiser Demon. Oh, there's like a million different names for all of them. Oh crap, where the hell did he come from? Got an extra backpack. Is this gonna be like a teleporter? Oh, I see Cycloid Emperors. Oh, I killed him? What's this? What's that orb? I can't pick it up. Why is the boss still at 100% if, I've killed one. Maybe I can only grab that orb when I'm low on health. Oh my god. Man, this is epic. Oh, there's like a ton of these. What do I do? Oh, I think I gotta do something else. Oh my god, what am I doing? Boss is still at 100%. What do I do? I just keep killing him? Oh my god. Need to have something on the background. Well, thank you for choosing me. I appreciate that. I need to attack the beam. Oh, the beam ain't opening. Where the fuck do I... Maybe I need to grab that. Yeah, okay, I think I get it. I think I need to grab the orb that they drop. I think that's the way. Or not. Oh, I'm actually damaging it. And now it's shielded. Oh my god. Or not, what the fuck? Oh, it is, it's very inconsistent. Why am I not seeing when I can damage it? They should it should give me a bit more information, like when I can damage it and when I can't. Because it's being very inconsistent now. So I can kill them for 10% when I kill one? Is that it? That's not working. Oh, it is now all of a sudden. Why are there no health pickups? It is cool, but there's like no health at all. And if I need to focus that thing in the middle, I can't fucking do anything against the cycloid. Feels very weird. Like, why do I not have any notification of when I can and cannot hit that thing? It is very inconsistent. See, now suddenly it has a shield again. It's very weird. I guess those orbs are health? Or not? Oh, now it's raining. I don't even know. And then I fucking explode. All of a sudden. Like, I start this with so much health and armor, what the fuck? Look how much damage that does. How ridiculous. That's ridiculous damage that they do, come on. Yeah, so when you down one, you can start attacking the thing. Now, my issue here is ammo. There's a lot of ammo lying around. Oh, now it's frickin' shielded again. Great. Ammos. Still trying to figure out if I can see when I can damage the thing and when not. So I'm gonna fucking save. Because that's what I need. Damaging it a little bit. I hope there's gonna be enough ammo. Oh my, and these pillars aren't helping either. Yeah, thankfully they do drop the health, that's a good thing. And these emperors thankfully die kind of easily. Oh my god, there's one right in front of me. That is not very good. Oh no, don't do that attack. That attack is stupid. One 1% per hit. Also, it's gonna be filled with all of these bodies here. Look how many bodies are laying around. Okay, I'll save again. That's not a good moment to have saved, but fuck it. What? How'd that kill me? Fucking fireman! Oh, that's so annoying. I'm not even getting any warning from the fire things. And I can't see shit because of the trillions of bodies. It's a very cool fight, but it is a little bit flawed in my opinion. See, and then just randomly another one appears. Yep, my asshole. It's cool, but it's just too much of a clusterfuck. The bodies aren't disappearing, you can't see shit. You can't see shit, everywhere's a fucking trap. So it's fucking annoying. You can't stand safe anywhere. There's gonna be another one up my ass, probably. See? There he is. See, you can't do anything! They're everywhere! Highly fucking annoying. See? Me. Why do you switch to that useless weapon? It's good, but not in this case. Oh, there got one got killed again. I'll save again. I'm done with that. Random explosions. Come on. Stop with the fucking bombs, man. They are so annoying. No. I'm gonna die. Also, I think ammo is gonna start being a problem soon. Look at this. There's traps everywhere, man. Why is he not dying? Come on. There we go. Well, I'm almost out of ammo now. There we go, there's a little bit more. Alright, let's use the flamethrower to kill these fuckers. Nope. Can't see anything. I probably will get copyright claimed. Fuck these cluster bombs, though. Fuck those grenades. Health. Good. Okay, we're almost done. Good thing I'm a save scumming bastard, right? But look, those fucking mines or grenades, they are cheap. You can't even see them because of the million of bodies over here, okay? There's so many bodies laying around. You can't see their attacks because they're just bodies. It's just bodies. That's what's annoying. And now I'm out of ammo again. I'm just walking around trying to find ammo. I don't see any ammo, dudes. I'm not gonna kill one with 20 fucking plasma. Yeah, see, there's no more ammo. They should have made them drop ammo if you're gonna have a boss fight like this. Look, there's no ammo. I'm sorry, but it's not balanced. You gotta give ammo. Okay? Yeah, fuck that. I died because I didn't have any ammo, okay? They should have given me ammo, because they're not giving me that. Very cool fight, but not properly balanced. No ammo. I mean, there was ammo, but it's not enough. And the lovely fucking trap things again. Let's use a plasma. That one has way more DPS. And, yeah, these pillars are also just not helping. Because you're fighting the enemies, and then suddenly the pillars will start fucking you over. I don't think so. See, and then another one spawns up your asshole. It's too much. Exploding fire gun. Well, I don't have that one, so they should have given it to me. Either way, there's no ammo. There's too much shit. There's fire fucking pillars. There's these bosses shooting stuff at you. And there's fucking fireballs falling out of the fucking sky as well. It's all too much. You can't look at 20 fucking different things. That makes no sense to have to do that. See, I move in front of the pillar, it immediately starts attacking me. Sadly, it doesn't feel very satisfying because I had to use cheats because of the lack of balance. Because there was no way I was gonna have enough ammo to deal with all of that. No way. Could have been much better if they actually dropped ammo. Well, that was cool for the rest. Right. That's pretty cool stuff. Also, I have some snacks left for New Year's. Plogue.
Smoke takes to the sky out of the dark abyss in front of what was the throat of foul and vicious bastards whose only aim was to kill you and all of your race. But it's over. The source is destroyed and the origin of all evil that haunted Earth is sealed. Your mission came to an end, and it's time to sit down and think about the last minutes, hours, and days. Time to realize what has happened. Realize that your return is the return of a hero that saved all humankind. It's a good feeling, but right now you have no idea about the meaning. But this will change sometime.
Wait, that's the end? I thought we still had another chapter. No, it is too late for the guessing now. Well, I'm sorry. Wait, that is the credits? I thought we still had something. Didn't we? I'm gonna have to check because I believe there was like another chapter, if I'm not mistaken. Alien throne, alien queen sprites. There's an alien queen? Why are they saying Duke Nukem 3D alien throne and alien queen sprites? Source guardian sprites. I guess that's what they mean with like the cycloid emperor. Numerous new monsters from Realm 667. But I gotta say, this was, you know, I think I'm gonna still do another chapter, but if this is the end, then I'm gonna say that this was absolutely amazing. You know, despite the annoying revenants with the hit scanners. You know, if I cut content, okay. Oh, well, then I'm gonna do that. Yeah, you know, if I were to play this at least another time, then I would know that the revenants only get killed with rockets, so, you know, that would have been better to know. But those are small things, you know. Some earlier maps lacked a little bit of pacing, but overall, I really loved the challenge of this ward. And yeah, level 1 had some ammo balancing issues, the last boss had some ammo balancing issues. But, like, when the few final levels, that those were, like, really challenging, and they were properly balanced with the ammo. Like, ammo was, like, running thin, but I still had ammo to take care of a lot of freaking encounters. And it was very good. Like, I'd say this was definitely one of the best mods I've ever played, but it's not perfect. It has some issues. Like, I wish I could give this a 10, but it just had some slight issues. I'm wondering if there's gonna be something at the end of these credits. I want to see that. But how often do you see a Doom mod that has like a credits screen like this? Definitely something that was a big project. Thanks for playing The Ultimate Torment and Torture. Oh, do we get something? A cutscene? Or is this just back to the menu? Maybe a little Easter egg. Uh-oh. Question mark? No, no question mark. I was expecting a question mark. Ugh. And then the music suddenly stopped. Okay. So, I believe Fury of Fire I have not played. Lost episode, Fury of Fire. So yeah, this is the last episode. We'll play that as well. Not sure how long it's gonna be, but we'll see. I do want to complete this. I've heard this song before in like a Garry's Mod video. Billy Mays versus the ShamWow guy. That song was in that video. See those assholes in a while. Where are these enemies? That's the one. I keep forgetting his name. But there's like a Garry's Mod video where they fight. Oh, there's like a lot of new enemies in here as well. I like these gargoyle imps, that's pretty cool. But yeah, there's a video where they fight in Garry's Mod and you hear this song as well. God damn it. Oh, good thing I just saved. Six hundred ninety-eight enemies. Holy fucking shit. That's a lot. Too bad we are pistol starting this. This is gonna be a little bit, Oh, did I fuck it up again? Did I not say Gorgon again? What did I say? Tell me what I said instead, accidentally. Gargoyle, right? Probably. Probably said gargoyle. I knew it. I keep saying gargoyle when I mean to say Gorgon. I mean, you can't blame me. It's all because of me playing God of War and then playing Heretic. It's all the fault of those games. That as well, but it's only the name that confuses me, not the looks or anything. Man, I really like these imps, they're freaking cool. They look evil and they have a cool death animation. I absolutely love them. These guys are fucking cool. Yeah, because it's not like I'm confused between gargoyles and gorgons in my mind. I know exactly what they are, but it's like, it's just a word. It's like, guh guh. Yeah. Because I know what a Cerberus is. As well. And there are a lot of others. Phoenix. Pegasus. Oh yeah, these shield mace imps are also pretty cool. I really like these. I Oh, that imp got denied. Like, hey imp, you wanna shoot me? Well, door closes.
Denied.
Frickin' imp. Okay, they're guarding for way too long. I do like them though, they're very cool, but their AI is a little bit annoying. They guard way too long. I'm also a big fan of these guys. That is a rocket. I want to keep going this way. There's also another split path. Oh, that is perfect pickup. This looks similar to another level I was at. Oh, lovely. It's red and has a projectile. Oh, I don't know that one. I do know about the blood demons, that they are red and they have like some skulls around their shoulders or something. Those are the ones I know. I don't believe those shoot a projectile. No clue what those red zombies do. Oh, they have a railgun. Been killing these for a while, but I've never seen them attack me yet.
Oops.
Our Croflon Force should be deactivated. Oops. Love the voice acting of this guy. These guys aren't as annoying as the imps, because they only put their shield up for a short amount of time. See, they're not nearly as annoying as the dudes from Hexen or the imps with the shield. Okay, so where do I want to go? In red. Where's that other part where I could go? Was that? Hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on. I need to find something. Yeah, this is the way. This is what I was looking for. These guys are kind of cool. I'm just not sure how well they fit in Doom. I'm not too sure. I don't know. I'm a little bit conflicted. They fit more into Heretic, but... So I kind of want to have an SSG about now. Or a rocket launcher, that also works. Happy they provided. This mod takes Doom somewhere else. Oh yeah, it definitely does. Hey Gorf, by the way. How you doing? Huh. This is crazy chaotic. It's very challenging, but I do like it. So I think it's a very, very cool mod. It lacks a little bit of pacing in the earlier levels, but damn, it's a very nice challenging mod in my opinion. And there were some slight issues with ammo balance during a boss fight, and like some ammo balance during the first level. There were also some, like a custom revenant that had hitscan weaponry and he would revive himself and only get properly killed if you jibbed him. That was like the only bullshit, but the rest is absolutely solid. Okay, so I need blue for this. I mean, just look at the sky as well, like these cliffs and everything. It's very cool. Ton of custom enemies. Most of them are not obnoxious. Because they're still killable. Some mappers out there, modders, just go out of their way to make an enemy absolutely unkillable. Which is highly annoying. Scythe 2 did that. Scythe 2 had like a very unkillable enemy that was and overpowered and had too much health for its own good. We've been here yet. Oh. A bat? Doom guy's killing bats? Happy New Year, Gorf, for the fifth time or something. But yeah, still might be some people out here who haven't had the New Year wished happy too, kind of. But I still wish everyone a Happy New Year as well. Okay, let's do this and die. Okay, let's try again. This time without dying. I'm not a big fan of having to instantly die when you just fall into the lava. Not a very nice thing. Good, now they're together. Not very happy that I'm only having a shotgun. Come on! Please do not flank me, dude. Well, okay, one's dead, so this should now be a piece of cake. Yeah, that's how we deal with two vials with just a shotgun. Like a boss. There we go. Grab some of these. Thank you very much. More reskinned cacos. Hmm. Now, if only I could get an SSG, that would be a fine addition to my collection. How about the Lost Souls can just go fuck off? Thank you. Okay, we have the Red Skull Key, that's good. Which is over here. We got one of these big badasses. Again, would have preferred to have an SSG against him. But this is a cut level, so, you know, normally you'd probably still have an SSG if this would still be in the main campaign. So I can kind of forgive this for it. I won't be as harsh on this level because they decided to cut it out but leave it as an optional episode to play, right? Now these guys are also pretty cool. They're basically like lightweight Hell Knights because they can't even well, they're actually more like heavyweight Pinky Demons, now that I think about it, because the Hell Knights can actually do a ranged attack. These guys can. They can only smack you. So they're pretty much harmless, as long as you kind of stay away from them. They're also slower than Pinkies. Tears. Oh yeah, we dealt with those motherfuckers in God of War, but they had like a spear and were a bit more dangerous than they are here. Alright, we opened the door. Meet Blue. Okay, let's go, I think that's the one around here. That's, I think, the one. Hello there, Nitro. Welcome, nice to see you again. Go get some of these Aphrits again. Again, not happy with the lava, just... Okay, that's a bit of a shitty encounter there. But I have a way to deal with that. Let's do that. Okay, we gotta switch again. There we go. I really like how these guys are in this WoD. They're absolute shit enemies in Scythe 2 with overpowered Seeking Rockets and overpowered health. But here they're actually pretty cool. I like their attacks. I like the fire they're spreading. And they're actually killable with a shotgun. Look at that cool fire spreading across the floor. I absolutely love that. That's so cool. Oh. Look at that. It's like the place is on fire. Like there's like a... some gasoline being spilled in a fire. Absolutely cool. The hell is with this? Oh, there's like a dude on the other side. Not put to bed, much trunky. Didn't sleep well last night. Oh, alright. Hope you sleep well, Agrith. And I hope you enjoy from the bed view. Where's the last? There he is. Come here. Don't have all day. Come on. Anytime. anytime. There we go. Alright, good. Now it's off to the blue door. Oh, we got one of those bastards again. Ow. That's not very nice. I honestly did not expect that guy behind the door. Let's hope there's gonna be some health nearby. A little bit, stim pack. Oh, I need yellow. Okay. I'm a little bit confused. Haven't I been everywhere? Unless I need to go to that door as well, which is blue. Let's check that out. Might be another door I gotta go through. Oh, and there's some health, that's good. I'm not sure if we needed a blue card or a skull key, but I'm gonna hope for a skull key. It's probably where the yellow key is. Alright. Yeah, these guys are absolutely epic. Very cool enemy. Ah, loving the fire. Because they have a unique thing. No, they're like a baron. But you can't stay very close to them because of the fire they're spreading, so you gotta keep your distance. It's very cool. That's out of bullets. Am I being sniped by a shit scanner? Oh, there's a bunch of bats coming at me. I think I got sniped again. Oh boy. Yeah, there he is. Fucking shotgunning prick. Oh, and a fucking bat. No. Two guys not gonna get killed by a bat. He's like, Doom Guy goes to hell and gets killed by a bat. How pathetic would that be? Yeah, I agree with you, Gorf. That is very annoying when, like, it's... You know, I understand that it's a good thing to notify me that I'm low in health, but it just distracts me from doing anything. So I'd rather just not have it. I do agree, it does annoy me as well. Yeah, exactly. You're already low on health, so it's like, gotta concentrate and be... Game is like, oh, I'm gonna distract you with annoying screen effects. Okay, it's kind of dumb that they spawn in the yellow key over here. Could have, like, just had it here so I could... Oh, lovely. They could have kind of had it there. If I could see it, but... these guys... Okay, that was my own stupid fault. I did not shoot properly. It's not how you shoot your rocket launcher. Not in front of a wall like that. I like how these guys are actually very low on health. They look like a spider mastermind, but they're actually pretty easily killable. Sadly, my health is a little bit low. So I gotta kind of watch out. I already got one now. There we go. See, they're not that tough. They balance the health out. Hey, Caligon. How you doing? Welcome. The ultimate torment and torture invasion after this. There's an invasion version of this. I gotta say, this is a very, very good WoD in Caligon. I'm playing the bonus episode now, the one that got scratched. But it's very good. I like the difficulty. This is like very, this is a very challenging WoD. And I like it. This is like a very doable but challenging WoD. The difficulty is like perfect in most cases. Ow. Another one. Two of them got their ass kicked by the barrel. Guess we gotta jump in this arena. This is pretty cool. Oh crap. Another survival thingy. Kinda wish I had the SSG. That would be too easy, I guess, huh? I'd normally want to just use my rockets against this Baron, but let's just save up those rockets for the higher waves. I kicked the barrel. Grab as much shit as I can. While I still can. That seems about it. Second wave! Uh-oh. Oh, give me that! Yes, thank you for the armor. Oh, that pinky got wrecked. So far, still don't need the rockets. I use a little bit of this though. And pull on anyway. Just keep shotgunning. A couple of Hell Knights are no biggie. Not in an area like this anyway. This is plenty of room to move. Plenty. Oh, that was a double kill at the end there. All right, what we got? We got more rockets. Oh crap, did I want to grab that? I think I was actually pretty good in health. Let's not grab that yet. Okay, this is starting to get a little bit more real. Let's get the Kakos first. Tree was blocking my ass. That's not nice. Don't want to use the rockets. Kinda. My shotgun is very low. That again. Oh, that was close. I think it's kind of funny they include the freaking Serious Sam kamikazes. I gotta say, this wave, kinda less challenging than the last one. Five out of six, what we get? I can I get rid of these guys? Ow. With a little bit of plasma. I'm getting a little bit worried about the ammo. I do have a lot of rockets though. That's gonna be my main usage right now. There's still a backpack, or did I pick that up? Okay, there's a box of shells, that's good. When would Lux, you know, nature's sticking to me? Yeah, exactly. Right down, trying to save the world, and that's how they pay me. Lock and load. Oh boy. Spider Mama joined the fight. Okay. If I could get her in fighting, that would be perfect. Oh, I really have nothing else but fucking rockets. That's pretty shit. Well, that's not very amazing. Yeah, that's a bit stupid. Yeah, baby. Lock and load. Okay, there was some shotgun ammo I just picked up. That's what I needed. Well, dude. Think. Oh, this should be enough. Okay. Okay. Well, I'm gonna be a pleb and save. Yeah, exactly what Light says. The reason I'm saving here is because this is a hit scanning bastard. Only have that much health. The tree doesn't help. Running out of ammo also does not help. Now, I did miss a decent amount of rockets. So I'm gonna just try again. This time with better accuracy. However, if I run out of ammo again, I'm gonna cheat me some. Yeah, they could have just a tiny little more ammo in there. A tiny little bit. I'm not a big fan of when they require you to be super precise with every single shot. Anyway. And then attack these fuckers as well. But no, again, I'll give it the pass of this is a cut level. So normally you'd be playing it while going through the campaign where you have the SSG, where you have more weapons and stuff, so you know. Oof. That was also very challenging. It's like they give you a little bit of maneuvering space, but not that much, but just enough. Cavern roof. Can maybe open it remotely. Oh, we're almost done. Oh my god, what the fuck is that? Oh my god. Rockets? Ammo? I might have to cheat more ammo. Or is it one that requires me to use the cyber? Yeah, of course, they're gonna expect me to do that, right? Not a big fan of that, but... Okay, they're doing it anyway now. Probably this asshole is kind of... not minding his own business. Well, one Cybe died. Oh, there's a third one. Well, if that third one can start a fight with them. Yeah, there we go. Haha, get wrecked. What, are you kidding me? That went so well. How the fuck did he hit me? I'll start again. Hopefully do it a bit better now, because they're like still tightly packed together. Last 3 pixels. God damn it. I needed more pixels. Or less, I don't know. Oh my god, these dodges. Did you see that? I was just casually dodging, like, rockets from 3 different angles. I'm not liking how they're all spreading apart here. Okay, one's down. Ow! Was focusing too much on that one on the left. That was my fault. Try again. Come on, boys. Should have some armor. I can't risk to pick it up right now. There goes the Cerberderman. Blah. Okay, fuck it. I'm gonna save. I'm not ashamed. Blah. Oh wow! I didn't even get hit. Sweet. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna say, these guys have not been doing a good job at killing the frickin' Cybees. I've been doing an utterly terrible job. I'm gonna have to clean everything up now. What the fuck? What was the chance? Seriously, what the fuck was the chance? I was so close. Fucking kidding me, come on. Oh, I heard one die. See, they're doing a better job now. Much better job. I'll pick that up, but okay. Oh, it was a one shot. GG. Wow. Okay. Well, finally. I should be able to just open it by using. Wait, what? The door leads up to a secret, so why should you be able to just open it by using it? Fair enough. That's a lot of cacos. It's pretty funny. Like those little fourth wall breaking things. This song never gets old for me. Oh. Yes. Can I go fuck? Okay, he's pissed off. Have fun. Have a nice date, you two. Can I have a berserk or chainsaw or, you know, something like that? Yeah! I have no ammo. I make the Kako infight with this thing, and I tell them to have a nice date. I run out of ammo again, fuck. perfect last shell I had and killed them both in one shot. Oh, that's so perfect. Some ammo balancing is very good in this mod, though. Not always, but sometimes they get it very right. Sometimes it just works. Unlike Fallout 76. Alright, we done did it. Oh, there's another pleb. There we go. Alright, is there any ammo left? No. Oh! Say what? What the? Where did they come from? Oh, they're invisible. My God, that's a little bit stupid. I don't even know what that means. Their nitro will come back. Man, I'm loving this room. What? There were more imps in here? You what? Alright, don't come fucking back, fucking imps. I'm playing the bonus episode, so I basically beat the game, but there was like a cut content episode that I'm doing now. I should be almost done. There's like 160-ish enemies left. Wilderbeasts. Which ones are the wilderbeasts? Because there's so many custom enemies, I don't know what all the names are. Fuck. Well, they're fucking around with the ammo again. I'm sorry, but the ammo is just not... See, now the ammo is being shit again. Because, like... How am I gonna fight a group of that without anything? They just gave me one box of shells or something and like one box of bullets. Oh, the Mancubi. I forgot you named them that. I'm sorry, but I'm gonna have to give myself ammo here. Because, I mean, come on, look at this. I'm zero ammo, and look at this, like, they're giving me. Are there stone imps in this? Fighters wouldn't die yesterday. Oh, I got to kill them eventually. And I also encountered them today again. Bosses. Yeah, we beat a couple of bosses. The final boss we also beat, that was pretty cool, but it was hard.
I've got a bad feeling about this. Whatever did this was very powerful.
Oh shit. Chainsaw. Wow. That's a heart. Uh-oh, well, here we go. Gonna pop out of there, I'd say. Okay. Oh, I had some slight problems with the Spider Mastermind in Doom 2016. The Saibi wasn't, I mean, it wasn't super hard, but it was not easy either, I'd say. It was fun to beat the Saibi. I think he might have fallen asleep. Oh, here we go. We got a boss fight. Big 3D clean queen. God. I do like her recolor. It's very cool. Kind of a pushover with the plasma, though. I say while a very powerful attack starts to fuck me. Another map.
I thought that would... You found them and you killed them. You killed all of these alien creatures before they could take control over the destroyed dark portal, and without the core itself, there is no chance for anyone else to reopen this. But what about you now? You are lost. Lost in the dead end in hell itself with no choice but waiting for someone to kill you. If you won't take the favor yourself, there is no way back but no way through anymore. For you, it is over.
True hero is the one whose exploits no one will ever discover.
Oh yeah, I tried Snap Map. It's absolutely terrible in my opinion. It's a funny little tool for on console, but it's not a real map editor. But, you know, I wouldn't have expected a fully fledged map editor for a game as modern as Doom 2016. It would have been cool. I have heard that there's going to be a lot more mod support for Doom Eternal, so I'm looking forward to seeing what that will be all about. This was a very cool extra level. I got a picture just slides to the right. I also tried a lot of Snap Map maps made by other people, like the highest rated ones, but not a single one was worth playing in my opinion. That it? Getting anything? Oh, well, we are officially done. We are officially done with the ultimate torment and torture. I am from the Netherlands. I'm with the ultimate. And torture, that was amazing. Holy crap, even that extra level was major fun despite there being a few ammo imbalance issues. That's literally like there's like few complaints, but the thing is, if you have a few complaints but the rest of the gameplay is like gigantically good, I'm like super happy that so good. Like, I can't give this a perfect 10 out of 10 because it does have some faults, but I can like definitely still call this one of my favorite wards ever, despite its flaws. Like, it's a flawed, amazing ward, and I want to give it a 9.5 out of 10 as well because it's oof, it's so good. Challenging is what I would describe this in one word. A few flaws with balance and pacing in a few tiny spaces. But the amazing challenging gameplay and interesting encounters make up for all of it. No, I'm not ending the stream. Not at all. I'm actually planning to continue with Doom 2016. That was the plan after Ultimate Torment and Torture. I would continue Doom 2016. What's gonna happen now? We are done with the Ultimate Torment and Torture. Absolutely amazing WOD. I fucking loved it. That's great. The next one on the list that we'll do soon will be The Outer Darkness. I have no idea what that is, but we will do that soon.